best-selling Spiderwick Chronicles, one of the most popular children's book series ever. So popular, it was turned into a feature film you may have seen and a video game. The author and illustrator of the series, Tony DiTerlizzi, is out with a new book. It's called The Battle for Wandla, and he joins us now. Tony, good to see you.
Thanks for having me, Corey.
I've heard so much about this series, and everybody's got a kid out there of that certain age probably has picked one of these books up and read them.
Yeah.
And now the book of Wandla, what's it called again? Sorry.
Well, it's the third in a trilogy. Yeah, it's taken me about 5 years to make all three.
And is this a similar, it's kind of a mystical journey here? What are we doing with this?
I was inspired by, like, Alice's Adventures in Wonderland and The Wonderful Wizard of Oz and Peter Pan. And all those stories are really about a heroine, a female protagonist, who kind of leaves the comforts of her home and goes into a magical land. And I was really inspired by those stories, and I thought, could I do, like, a 21st century version? I could do a story about a girl kind of leaves home. But instead of, like, you know, Tin Men and Mad Hatters, I loved Star Wars as a kid, so I had to like aliens and robots and stuff like that. So it's kind of a journey, and it's really about finding home and what is really defines our home and what defines our family.
The Battle for Wandla sounds really cool. So I know you're also in town to talk to kids, to students, and you've done some of that already in town and trying to get them connected to the idea of using their imaginations. Tell me more about that.
Yeah, well, you know, I've been on book tour now for a little over a week. We do schools. I was in Naperville yesterday, had a great time. And, you know, I when you're in elementary school, Corey, a lot of kids are encouraged to write creatively. They're encouraged to draw a lot. When I get to a middle school, about half those kids, and by the time I get to high school, there's like two or three art nerds that are like, oh, I like to draw. And that always, I've been wondering a lot about that. So what I like to do is kind of present myself as a kid who daydreamed a lot in school. Not a disruptive kid, not a kid who got in a lot of trouble, but a kid who always had his head in the clouds and coming up with stories and ideas. And that there's something you can do with that. There's something, a career you can kind of make out of that. I mean, we as Americans, we love stories. We go to movies every weekend. We play these video games. Well, those are all, they all need creative storytellers, both artists and writers, to do that. So I try to present myself as a person who's made a career out of it.
That's terrific. And so what would you say to parents who maybe have a kid that's sort of that direction? How do you keep it going and nurture that?
Well, I mean, a lot of people are like, oh, you can draw, man, you're so lucky. A lot of kids can draw, a lot of kids can write. Right. I was really fortunate in that my parents just encouraged it, and I had teachers in my life that were also really encouraging. They recognized it, they saw it, they encouraged it. And I think that's probably the most important thing, to be honest with you, Corey, is just if parents see that their kid really loves to write and draw, nurture that. You never know what can happen.
Could be the next children's author and illustrator.
That's it. That's right.
You're also involved in a new project I know you're excited about, based on Star Wars, the original trilogy children's book. Tell us about this.
Well, Lucasfilm called me last fall, and when Lucasfilm calls...
You answer.
You answer, yeah. It's the red phone. I better
exactly.
Get it. No, they gave me a ring, and they knew I was a big Star Wars fan. I'm a huge Star Wars nut, and... They had the original concept art by a man named Ralph McQuarrie, and Ralph worked directly with George Lucas when he was first visualizing the original film in the 1970s. And they had all this artwork, and they said, hey, is there any way you can like take this and put it together and make a book for children using this artwork? Write their story, retell it, and put it in a picture book. And I was like, I'll do whatever you want.
Yeah, I'm your guy.
Whatever it is. Here's my firstborn. Here's the mortgage to the house. I'm in.
That's terrific. And when will that be out?
That'll be out this October in time for Star Wars Reads Day, which is a holiday that I didn't know existed, but now I do.
Well, look forward to it. Tony, very nice to meet you. Continued success. And it's a pleasure to have you with us today.
Thanks for having me.
Tony DiTerlizzi in the new book, The Battle for Wandla. All right, let's take a break. Up next on Good Day, some new technology.